Thank you. These openings are furnished with projecting tubes of section area A, B, C, D. These projecting tubes are fitted with airtight pistons P, Q, R, S, which are capable of sliding into the projecting tubes. Fill the vessel completely with a liquid. The only forces acting on the liquid are the forces applied on the pistons P, Q, R, and S. Now push the piston P down into the liquid. What do you observe? We observe that the other pistons Q, R, S are moving outward. Why is it so? This is because the pressure exerted on the piston P is transmitted equally in all the directions in the liquid, thus moving the other pistons. This proves Pascal's law.
A hydraulic jack is the device used to lift heavy loads. Today, we will explore the insights of a hydraulic jack and understand its working principles. The hydraulic jack uses two advantages to multiply the applied forces. One is the principle of Pascal's law, and the other is the principle of levers. The hydraulic jack has a smaller piston, which is connected to a larger piston using a hollow tube. Let's understand how a hydraulic jack uses this setup to multiply the applied force. Here is a simple setup to demonstrate the basic principle. A smaller cylinder with cross-sectional area of A1 is connected to a larger cylinder with cross-sectional area of A2 by using a hollow tube. When a force, F1, is applied on the smaller piston, the pressure of F1 by A1 is developed inside the smaller cylinder. This develops a pressure of F2 by A2 on the larger cylinder. Since the system is confined, Pascal's law is valid. So we can say that pressure at smaller cylinder is equal to the pressure at larger cylinder. This clearly tells us that force at larger cylinder is pressure at smaller cylinder multiplied by area of larger cylinder. Due to this reason, a large amount of force is developed in the larger piston when a small force is applied on the smaller piston. Now let's see how the hydraulic jack uses the principle of levers. Levers can be used to exert a large force over a small distance at one end by exerting only a small force over a greater distance at the other. If we apply a small force at the point A of the lever and displace it through a long distance, then the point B of the lever moves to a short distance but with greater force. This same principle is used in the hydraulic jack to multiply force. Now let's see some practical circuits showing the working of an actual hydraulic jack. It consists of a reservoir to store hydraulic fluid. A hollow tube connects the reservoir to the smaller cylinder. Another hollow tube connects the smaller cylinder with the larger cylinder. Now the animation shows the working of the hydraulic jack.
Let's take a look at the components that make up a typical hydraulic braking system. we have the brake pedal, the push rod, the servo, the master cylinder, the reservoir, and hydraulic lines. The brake pedal transfers the mechanical force applied by the driver to the push rod. The push rod transfers the mechanical force applied by the brake pedal through the servo to the master cylinder. The brake servo or vacuum booster assists the driver by applying additional force to the braking system. The master cylinder converts non-hydraulic pressure from the driver's foot on the brake pedal into hydraulic pressure. When braking, pistons with seals and springs in the master cylinder create hydraulic force, which pressurizes the entire hydraulic system. Brake fluid returns to the master cylinder when pressure is released. The reservoir holds sufficient brake fluid to stop air getting into the hydraulic system. Finally, we have the hydraulic lines, which carry the brake fluid to the front and rear brakes. Now, let's take a look at the hydraulic system in action. Here, we can see the wheels turning. Pressing the brake pedal extends a push rod through the brake servo and into the master cylinder. The master cylinder pressurizes the entire hydraulic system and forces brake fluid through the hydraulic lines. Releasing the brake pedal reverses the process. The hydraulic pressure on the entire brake system is reduced, allowing brake fluid to return to the master cylinder. A combination of seals in the caliper and springs in the brake drum then return the brakes to their original position, allowing the wheels to turn freely once more. Brake fluid travels through the hydraulic lines, applying pressure to the caliper or wheel cylinder pistons, which in turn create the friction force required to slow the wheels. And that's the basics of how a hydraulic brake system works.
The vehicle's brake system employs hydraulics. This means that a force is transmitted via a liquid. The principle is based on a closed system with pistons, cylinders, and a special liquid. But how does it work? Liquids have one very special physical characteristic. They're incompressible. Unlike air. That's why hydraulic systems must be free of air. Within a hydraulic system, pressure is exerted on a liquid. By means of this force, the space within a cylinder is reduced and the liquid is displaced. The resulting pressure acts the same at any point in the system, retaining its magnitude. If two cylinders of equal size are connected to each other, the liquid transmits the exerted force while maintaining the ratio. What does that mean for a vehicle? The foot exerts a force on the brake pedal. It sets the brake fluid within the brake master cylinder in motion. The fluid is forced through the connected tubing to the wheel brake cylinder. The exerted force is thus transmitted. This principle remains the same, even if more than one wheel brake cylinder is connected. The force continues to be transmitted uniformly. However, it's divided into four equal parts, proportionally reducing the distance moved by the pistons. In a vehicle, this is called a single circuit brake system. For increased safety, the system is separated into two circuits. Depending on the vehicle concept, the brake system acts separately on the front and rear axles or in a diagonal direction. This provides increased safety in case one brake circuit should fail. A hydraulic system not only transmits forces, it also multiplies them. For this to happen, the operating piston's diameter must be smaller than that of the working piston. It's the same in a vehicle. The diameter of the brake master cylinder is smaller than that of the wheel brake cylinder. The force exerted by the brake pedal is thus not only transmitted, but also multiplied. The brake system works with a special liquid. To ensure reliable operation, it has to meet certain requirements. It should operate equally well at low temperatures as at very high temperatures, even when the brakes themselves are operating under extreme heat. That's why the brake fluid must be exchanged regularly. The fluid is transported via steel pipes and brake hoses from the brake master cylinder to the wheel brakes. For the rear axle brakes, the pipes are guided along the underbody. Brake hoses are used in movable areas. Additional components like the brake servo allow for comfortable brake operation. And systems such as the anti-lock brake system further improve driver comfort and safety. Thank you.